Ronald Kennedy, but he could not come here. And I worked in Narok Water from 2014 to 2016 and developed HOSE-HOGE application for non-revenue water management. And I would like to introduce how GIS can approach non-revenue water reduction. And first, I want to ask you, how many people knows what is non-revenue water? Can you raise a hand if knows? Nobody knows? Ah, you knows. Okay. Maybe I will going to explain. Maybe. And the first, where is Narok? Is maybe Kenya is located in East Africa. And Narok is about 200 kilometers away from Nairobi, capital city. And Narok, majority is Maasai people, and population is about 60,000 people. And major economic income is tourism from Maasai Mara National Reserve, which is the seven wonder of the world. It's like wild beast crossing river, or maybe a lot of animal wildlife. Maybe it, and here I just want to show you Narok Water is here under Ministry of Water and county government is asset of owner and county government dedicated to water service provider here. And our Narok company is, Narok Water is here. And about Narok Water, it's Nawasco. It's Narok's water supply started from a long time ago. And the oldest plant is 1930s. And the 1970s, 80s expanded. And 2016, Japanese government funded to construct a new water treatment plant. So Narok, like a water treatment plant museum, from oldest one to latest one, can see all. And I stayed from 2014 and started to use HOSE-HOGE operations. Before that, Narok Water just used paper map to do the operation of water. And Narok has two areas to supply water, Narok Town and Ororunga Town. Today I focus about Narok Town. Connection is about 4,700 households connection. And this is the picture of old treatment plant. This is constructed in 1930s, oldest one. And this is the 1980s. Yeah. And this design capacity is about 1,000 cubic meter per day. But before, it produced 2,000 cubic meter per day. So water quality was very good. And also, this central water treatment plant is located in the lower elevation area. So it really high cost to pumping everywhere. And so not enough water in town. And this north water treatment plant is constructed in 2016, funded by Japanese government. And this design capacity is about 4,000 cubic meters. So it is now we have the 5,000 cubic meter per day. It is enough for 60,000 people. Yeah. And so and this is a picture. This is intake and pumping from to the treatment plant about 80 meters. And this is clarification and sand filters and clear water reservoir. Yeah. And this is a picture of non-revenue water. Non-revenue water is like the leakage, it's burst. And this is also leakage. And there are a lot of water left, illegal connection like that. And before North Water Treatment Plant constructed, we were about 50% of non-revenue water, which is maybe if produced 1,000 cubic meter per day, maybe 500 cubic meter lost and cannot get revenue from that water. Yeah. So because there is no water, so water kiosk, there are very long line. People collect water. And this is a definition. This is what is the non-revenue water. And this non-revenue water mainly focuses is water losses, and which is GIS can approach. And water losses divide two. One is commercial losses, and another one is physical losses. Commercial losses is like illegal connections or maybe meter reading error. And physical losses is leakage. Leakage on distribution pipe or maybe house connection. Like that. So we minus system input minus revenue water become non-revenue water. And this is my developer's web GIS system in Narok Water. We are using PostGIS and use map server and leaflet. And in non-revenue water, billing system is very important. But Narok Water's billing system is a very old system, and the database is a DBF file. So we have the function to import DBF to PostGIS to use billing data for non-revenue water management. And about data collection, we use the Trimble GPS and import to QGIS to collect and edit. But because of the security issue, maybe there are a lot of customer information in water company, so our GIS can be used in company network only. And from here, I want to introduce reducing physical losses leakage. And for reducing physical losses, first we need to map all of water pipeline network and install flow meter maybe after water treatment plant and or after tank. And then we create the district metered area. And we monitors, we measuring water volume every time. So we can know, so we can prioritize which DMA needs to be improved. So without mapping the water pipe network, we cannot know how we can reduce the non-revenue water. GIS is very important. And this is our example of district meters area. This is Muamba DMA. And because of lack of company budget, flow meter is still not installed yet. But this is central business district area, the DMA. We already installed flow meter. And after prioritize DMA to reduce non-revenue water, we have two options. One is replacement of pipeline, which is very high cost, but this is the best way. And another one is leakage detection and repairing. This required budget is less than replacement, but it is still necessary to install some flow meters to create DMA. And NAROC got the support from Japan to replace all of network from 2016. So before we have about 40% of non-revenue water, and we now reduced to 20% of non-revenue water. But and the pipeline is new, so leakage is almost reduced. And now it's mostly commercial losses. Yeah. And about reducing leakage, important is recording history of repairing leakage. So our GIS system can produce the O&M worksheet with maps. So in Africa, most of people cannot draw a map. So if let them handwrite the map where they repaired, we cannot know the location. So if GIS can produce some template with maps, it is easier to record. Yeah. And after recording the history of leakage, we can know regular point where there is a burst. And from here is reducing commercial losses. And in the water company, customer care is very important. If customer is not satisfied water service, company cannot get any revenue from customer. And so if there is a GIS, we can search customer from GIS system very easily. And also we have the function to produce the payment information from the GIS system. So through those functions, our customer care service improved. And NAROC has a very big issue about the adjustment work. What is the adjustment? It's meter reader go to household connection, overbilling intentionally, and register reading on the billing system and produce the water bill. This is a normal procedure. The customer will know the too much expensive water. So complain to the company, and customer care officer and the revenue officer discuss with customer about corruption. And maybe 1,000 Kenya shilling bill, maybe customer care officer can reduce to the 200 shilling and give him 500 shilling for corruption like that. So GIS system import from billing system and export the list of adjustment to for now manager monitor all of adjustment to try to find out corruptions. But we still have a lot of corruptions. So this is a very big challenge for reducing commercial losses. And also meter reading is very important. And before we created manually meter reading sheet by Excel, there are a lot of new meter missing. And PostGIS can produce the meter reading sheet automatically, synchronized with the billing system. So we can save cost to create and reduce errors on sheet. Yeah. And also new connection registrations is very important to prevent the illegal connections. And before, our new connection registers procedure is not good. And customer apply in office or field, but a lot of connection never registered. Nobody knows where there is a connection. So we created the new procedure. Customer apply must in office and first register in the Excel sheet and make sure to register billing system. After that, GIS produces the uncaptured connection list like this. So mapping people easily to map the new connection. The mapping new connection can prevent the illegal connection increased. Yeah. And also, Narok Water is the Narok Water's budget is limited. So we cannot create district meters area for easy management of non-revenue water. So we have GIS divided some consumption per village to create the consumption list. So instead of DMA, we at least can know the trend of consumption to prioritize the area to reduce non-revenue water. And this is the conclusion of approach to non-revenue water reduction. And repairing leakage and recording leakage history. And this is for physical losses reduction and also replacement of pipe and the creation of DMA is physical losses. And for commercial losses is customer care works improvement and detection of corruption from adjustment work and improvement of new connection registration to reduce illegal connection and improvement of meter reading accuracy. So this is how GIS can approach to non-revenue water reduction. But GIS is just starting point for non-revenue water management. After mapping, we have to do a lot of things to use the GIS. But for the many WSPs, it is difficult to use GIS because of lack of budget and knowledge and human resources. So I think FOS4G can make non-revenue water be better for water service providers in Africa. Yeah, that's Ashe Oren. Ashe Oren, it means thank you in Maasai language. Yeah, thank you for your attention. Any questions? Yeah.
Thank you for the presentation. Quick question, were you able to map the illegal abstraction points to show any similar characteristics to avert any of this in the future? And then another question is, are there any remote sensing tools that you would be able to use for the leak detection?
Yeah, thank you for question. About the mapping of illegal connection is very difficult because nobody knows where there is an illegal connection. That is illegal connection. So important is make the district meters area to divide the small area and measuring water flow every time and water flow and consumption every time. And prioritize area. So we can know maybe this area has a lot of illegal connection or leakage. And yeah, So, and leakage also, maybe leakage detection also, unless we measure water, we cannot know where there is water. Maybe some leakage we can use some leakage detector to find the leakage, but without DMA, it is very difficult to find. Maybe because most of leakage is underground, cannot know. We cannot walk without any plan, maybe. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
How many people does the new plant serve?
How many? So now I think about 4,700 water connection, and if one household has maybe 5 people, maybe 25,000 around there. But yeah. Any questions?
I've seen some work locally in Kenya of people managing such connections and networks using sensors within the network, which an organization like NAWASCO would be able to monitor these leakages. So I don't know, maybe in your future plans, do you intend to use such technology, which is currently being used in other counties within the country? Yeah.
Thank you, question. Maybe after I installed HOS4G in Narok Water, maybe Narok Water is actually the first water company in Kenya to start using HOS4G. And after that, other water company asked me about the HOS4G installation in their company. So I just introduced to them our approach to the several water companies in Kenya. So I think now, and Kenya Water Service, there is a Kenya Water Service Providers Association, which has a very active GIS task group. And they are very interested in HOS4G application. So, and after I left Kenya 2016, I think they still continue to use HOS4G for leakage detection.